Hi, my name is Diane Dickerson, and if you don't know me, I am the very proud CEO of the Bangor Region YMCA. I'm reaching out to you all from our very empty fitness center, as you can see. It is missing you, and I am certainly missing you. I want to tell you about what RY is currently doing to support you as members and as program participants during this very difficult time. As you well know, we sadly had to close our fitness center, our pool, and the entire wellness side of our facility, but we are getting very creative with other ways to keep you healthy and stay connected. Currently, to keep our community safe, even every Bangor Region YMCA program and facility is closed, except for our child care program. And staff who can perform their job from home are doing so. So that is why I am standing here so alone. We've been requested to keep our child care program open as a resource for parents who remain in the workforce, particularly those in the healthcare and the first responder fields. The decision to offer child care has been made with extremely careful consideration and counsel from our staff, from local government officials, from YUSA, and our public health and our healthcare experts. The governor has not advised child care centers to close, and we are continuing to follow CDC and state guidance with daily consultation with our local officials, as well as daily connection with other local child care providers to ensure that providing child care remains the right thing to do, the best decision for our community, and that we are fulfilling the needs of all the kids in the community. Because our YMCA is a daily support for you and thousands of other people in our region, we're doing everything that we can to provide you with as many services and resources to support you during this time. So let's start with fitness, since we are in the fitness center. We know that many of you have suddenly lost your daily routine, your social connection, and your physical fitness regimen, all while experiencing higher than normal anxiety. So for that reason, our staff is working very hard to create and implement a variety of virtual workout programs for you, for our specialty groups, such as our cardiac rehab or our Live Strong programs, and for small groups. And we're doing a lot of outdoor fitness programs where people can spread apart and be safe and still get exercise and breathe the air. In fact, Jen and Courtney and Carmen are now calling themselves Diane's Angels. They will be continuing to change all of these videos up and these different workouts, and they will be adding new ones all the time. I think you're going to have a blast with it. These are on Facebook, but we are also developing a virtual YMCA webpage, which will offer free fitness classes and programs from many of your beloved trainers and fitness instructors. Call or email me and let me know if there are certain things that you want that we're not providing, because we would be more than happy to do so. And yes, for all of you Chad fans, yes, he too will be doing videos. We'll have specific programs, as I said, for our cardiac rehab group, for our Live Strong group, for Strong for Life, for Fit Over 50, and for our Why Weight programs. We're also offering MOSA classes online for all members, and we have already begun some small group outdoor social and wellness fitness programs. So please visit our Facebook page to see all of these resources, and as soon as our virtual YMCA webpage is live, it will be posted to our website and members will receive an email from me letting them know that it's ready to go. Many of you rely on us support beyond our health and wellness programming. We will be reaching out via phone to all of our members in our different programs such as Second Wind, our cardiac rehab, our caring connections, and others to see how we can support you during this time. We continue to offer our support group virtually, and we will implement special phone calls and phone trees to ensure that we support one another all throughout this process. While we cannot see you at the Y every day, we want you to know that we are still here serving you. So please call us at the Y, and our staff will connect you to ensure that we meet your physical and your emotional needs in any way that we can. If any of our members are in need of social connectedness or just a friendly visit or toilet paper, for goodness sakes, or food or fitness consultation or anything else, call, because we will absolutely do whatever we can to help serve you. The YMCA facility is not what connects us. It's not the building that connects us. It's we. It's us. We are what connect to one another. So it's a hard time for everyone, and I know that, and it will only be getting harder. Like many small businesses and other nonprofits across the world, caring for our employees is our priority, and the financial toll of this pandemic will be crippling to our organization. Many of you have been so incredibly wonderful and kind to call us, to share your support, to give us encouragement, and to tell us to keep drafting your membership dues to support the Y. And we could not be more grateful. We thank you so much for reaching out, and it's been incredibly inspiring for myself, and I know for the staff as well. Because of this outpouring of love and support, at this time we will not be automatically adjusting our membership billing. However, we will be able to put your accounts on hold if that is what you decide to do. We can put it on hold for up to 3 months upon request from you. We understand that everyone is being affected differently, and we certainly do not want to burden families who are experiencing lost income. Call us at 941-2808 if you need to make this request. However, if your family is in a position to continue your membership, please stay with us. We would be so appreciative. We cannot tell you how much this means to all of us. While we cannot predict the future, it is my sincere hope that we will be returning to operations in the near future. Until that time, I remind you that our YMCA staff is still here for you, and I will continue to be reaching out via emails and videos. So please call if there is any way that we can support you. I am sending you my thoughts and my prayers. I thank you all. We miss you so much at the Y, more than you can possibly imagine. So please be safe and take care. Thank you so much.